Please stand for our graduates. Ladies and gentlemen, members of the Board of Trustees, faculty, staff, honored guests, graduates, welcome to the 46th annual Spring Commencement Exercises at East Central College. Please remain standing now for our national anthem.
Say, can you see by the dawn's Early light, what so proudly we hail at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watch, were so gallantly streaming. And the rockets red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet reign o'er the land of the free and the home of the
Please be seated now and enjoy this special performance by Voce Blu under the direction of Dr. Timothy Sexton.
Do.
Thank you, Dr. Sexton and Voce Blue, for such a wonderful performance, and to Joshua Adams for leading us in the national anthem. Wonderful job. I'm Jon Bauer, and it's a privilege to serve as president of East Central College. I'm joined today on the platform by a number of distinguished individuals. To my right, your left, the East Central College Board of Trustees. These individuals are elected by voters in the district and govern the college. I would ask them to rise and remain standing. We will acknowledge them at the end. Ann Hartley, Board President. Dr. Joe Stretger, Vice President. Don Koppelman, Secretary. Ina Cookie Hayes, newly elected trustee. And Dr. Eric Park, also newly elected to the board this past April. Ladies and gentlemen, your Board of Trustees. To my left and to your right are the administrators of the college. They include Vice President of Student Development, Shelley Allen. Vice President of Finance and Administration, Phil Penna. And Vice President of External Relations, Joel Depker. I would especially like to recognize this afternoon Vice President of Instruction, Jean McCann, our Chief Academic Officer. Vice President McCann is retiring after 24 years at East Central. She began her tenure at East Central as a member of the math faculty, became Chief Academic Officer in 2000, and will retire at the end of June. She has provided leadership for the faculty and the college, and today will be her final commencement exercises at East Central. So please join me in congratulating Vice President Jean McCann for 24 years of service to East Central College. What a glorious day. If you're involved in education, commencement is the high point of the year. This is the World Series, the Super Bowl, the Olympics. These diplomas are the Oscars for best performance in a classroom. These are the Tonys, the Emmys, the Pulitzer Prizes for these students. Today marks the culmination of a journey that began some time ago and undoubtedly has involved challenges, frustrations, tears, laughters, ups and downs, but ultimately success. You are here today, graduates, because you stayed the course on that journey and you're about to realize your dream of being a college graduate. I love everything about this day. Honestly, I think about commencement throughout the year. How can we make the ceremony better? What can we do, something that's different? Who would be a good keynote speaker? How long until graduation day? Pardon the pun, but I love the pomp and circumstance of this day. The tradition of the academic regalia and the colors representing schools and disciplines. The tradition of the mace crafted from a tree that grew right on this property before it ever was a college campus. And yes, I love pomp and circumstance, the music. But more than anything, I love the look on the faces of the graduates, and I love the stories that belong to each of them. Those of us in higher education live and work for this day, not because of the pomp and circumstance, but because we have the privilege of seeing these students join a long line of college graduates here at East Central and across the nation and around the world. We know the importance this day had in our lives, and we revel in knowing that these students are experiencing that same excitement and sense of accomplishment on this day. And so I love this time, but I love the time after the ceremony, talking with students and family and friends, taking pictures, eating, laughing, celebrating these stories. And I want to tell you some of those stories. Mercedes Love plans to continue her studies at Central Methodist University to pursue a career in education. Like many students, she didn't start at East Central, but transferred here from another institution. She says, "I knew instantly this was the right place for me. The teachers were very helpful and took time to know their students. They fought hard to help me succeed." She and Katrina Marshall, who is also going to Central Methodist, credit Greg Stotler in particular for their success at East Central. Malia Metz is a nursing graduate. "Every teacher made me feel important and cared about," she says. In particular, faculty members Nancy Mitchell and Judy Beaker were especially helpful to Malia as she studied here. I always raved about East Central's nursing program, but now that I will be a graduate, I will promote the college and program even more so. I am so happy to be an ECC grad. Sydney Phelps credits Dr. Fatima Nichols for her success. Sydney will be transferring to Washington State University in hopes of eventually becoming a veterinarian. She was a student worker in the science department as well as a student tutor, which she says helped her maintain her skills in math, chemistry, and biology. Rachel Cackley is a third generation East Central graduate celebrating with her family today. Ann Candlebender says simply her experience at East Central has been nothing short of wonderful. Richard Hudnick pushed her to succeed even when she didn't think she could. These past few years haven't been exactly easy. It's been hard, tiring, and just plain out exhausting. And at times I thought to myself, am I insane? But as I walk on Saturday, I know it was all worth it, 100%. My children are the reason for my continued efforts during this time. I can't wait for them to see their mommy in cap and gown. Dora Lafferty works over 50 hours a week, and that's before she cracks the books at East Central. A married mother of two, this former high school dropout is getting a degree in business management, graduating with honors, and plans to pursue a bachelor's degree. Teen Huen is majoring in industrial engineering technology. He's interned at Hennigus Automotive in New Haven and has been offered a job after graduation. He credits Nathan Esbeck for helping make the connection for the internship and eventually his career. I will be a strong and confident falcon to fly to my goal and my dreams, he says. Lauren Dell is getting her degree at the age of 59. I was so busy with life and raising children, I had no time to pursue my degree. I want my children, grandchildren, and great-grandchildren to understand it's never too late to get your college degree. You should never stop learning. Victoria and Ty Witt, the parents of five, are graduating together today. They came back to college as adults to set the example for their children as they entered high school. We could not expect our children to listen simply to words if we did not conquer the challenge ourselves. They'll graduate with honors today, a strong example indeed. And Ryan Daisy will be transferring to Missouri State University in Springfield to pursue a bachelor's degree in marketing management. Listen to Ryan. Without the passion and insight of those like Jerry Amaloza, Richard Hudnick, and Mrs. Cassett, I may never have discovered my own passion for the field of business. I will never forget the inspiring and truly transcending discussions I have had with Mrs. Kolb in my English classes, or Mr. Gifford in Intro to Philosophy. All in all, East Central has done more than just give me an education. East Central, both as an institution and family, has absolutely changed my life. In closing, Ryan thanks his mom, Sherry Wall, who graduated from here in 2011. He and his two older brothers followed in her footsteps. We could not have done this without her. These are just some of the stories of our graduates today. These are the reason we're here. And these stories are the reason we'll be here 50 years from now and beyond. And I hope you notice that these stories are not those of individual accomplishment. The students and I know that the success we're celebrating today is due to the commitment and dedication of our faculty, who have challenged them personally and academically so that they could get to this day. We know that your success is your success. Congratulations to our faculty today. The success of our students is also due to the support of other staff at the college who are committed to the East Central College mission. From that day a long time ago, when you first talked of getting a college degree, someone here helped you all the way from admission through today's ceremony. Their hard work is paying off today. Student success is everyone's job at East Central College, every single employee. So today I say to my fellow employees, job well done. And finally, to our graduates, congratulations. You make us look good. We're proud of you this day and wish you all the best in the future. Our speaker today could have been one of those students that I mentioned. Rob Dixon is president and CEO of the Missouri Community College Association, MCCA. Representing the state's 12 community colleges, MCCA provides government advocacy, networking and information and education resources for its members. It's the largest higher education association in the state with approximately 2,000 members. Rob's career is listed in your program. I think what's most pertinent today is that Rob is, like me and many others in this room, a community college graduate. He joined the Marine Corps after high school, where he served as an intelligence analyst in Afghanistan and Pakistan immediately after the 9/11 terrorist attacks. He was recognized with several commendations and awards for leadership and performance. He received an honorable discharge as a sergeant after 5 years in the Marines. He then attended St. Charles Community College, where he earned an Associate of Arts degree in political science. From there, he transferred to the University of Missouri, St. Louis, where he earned a bachelor's degree in political science and later a master of public administration from Missouri State University. Rob has provided tremendous leadership, vision, and energy to the community colleges in Missouri. He's passionate about our students, and he understands that his work in Jefferson City, around the state, and in Washington, D.C., is not really about the association itself. It's about nearly 100,000 students who attend a community college in Missouri. More specifically, his work and ours is about Mercedes and Malia and Sydney and Teen and Ryan and all the rest. Rob's wife Melanie, his son Eddie, and his father Bob are here with us seated in front. It's my privilege now to introduce a tremendous friend and great colleague, Rob Dixon.
Well, thank you for that introduction, Dr. Bauer, and thank you all for the opportunity to be here with you today and to share in this moment. You know, Dr. Bauer mentioned my work at the Missouri Community College Association, but he did not mention the fact that he's a key leader in our organization. In addition to serving as the president here at East Central and serving as a key leader in your community, he's also a key leader across the state of Missouri and serves as the chairman of our organization, and it's an honor and a privilege that I have to get to work with Dr. Bauer every single day. So thank you. It's humbling, and it's an honor to be here with you today on this truly important moment. It's an exciting moment. Congratulations, graduates. Job very well done. Today is your day, and I sincerely hope that you take just a moment to really soak in what's going on around you for the rest of the day today. Congratulations, too, to the faculty, to the staff, to the administrators here at East Central. Everything you've done along the way has helped these graduates get to this point, and you truly inspire excellence in all of us. Congratulations to the families, to the friends, to everybody else who has supported you graduates along the way. From personal experience, I know that it's not something that you can do alone. It truly is a great day. As you heard from Dr. Bauer, my job, I have the opportunity and the privilege of representing all 12 of Missouri's community colleges, the 5,000 some odd employees of those community colleges, and the nearly 100,000 community college students just like you all across the state. In this role, I have the opportunity to see how issues affect not just one community, but really our entire state and how they interplay in a lot of different areas like higher education policy, economic development, workforce development, and many others. I'm a lifelong Missourian, and I truly love this state. Because of my pride in Missouri and because of my role in a statewide organization, I always try to rely on the wisdom of famous Missourians anytime that I can. And I think Mark Twain is one of the best. As I was preparing for today, I came across another commencement speaker who also cited the Bard of Hannibal, and I think it's some of the best advice on speechifying that I've ever seen. Now, Mark Twain once advised people that the very first thing that they should do when they get up in the morning is to eat a live frog. You get out of bed, you swallow a live frog. He said that if you do that, no matter what happens to you for the rest of the day, it can only get better. And I guess it really can't get much worse, that's for sure. But that other commencement speaker also noted that that same logic is used to determine the order of the program for a graduation ceremony. You put the commencement speaker early on, and then it only gets better from there. But today really is about the graduates, and this is your day. And again, I hope you take that moment to think about that. But as I was really thinking about what I wanted to say today, I thought back on my own commencement ceremonies, first at the community college, then later from the university, and finally from graduate school. And as I look back, all three of those speakers had one thing in common, and that is, I don't remember a single thing about them. I don't remember who they were, I don't remember what they said, and I don't remember what they talked about. Honestly, though, I'm really honored that you'll be citing this speech to your grandchildren someday. But all I remember about those extremely important milestone moments in my life is that I just wanted them to be over, finished, so that I could go home and celebrate. And so as I was thinking about today, I really couldn't draw any inspiration from those commencement ceremonies, so I had to dig back a little bit deeper. And I started thinking about my sixth grade English teacher, Mrs. Schmidt. And she was one of those teachers, and I think everybody has one of those teachers, that person that just sticks with you. And you can still remember, I can still remember certainly, some of the things that she said and some of the things that she did. And back in school, I was one of those kids that I worked hard, but I always raced to get my work done quickly, just as soon as possible, so that I could move on to the next thing, and then the next, and then the next. Mrs. Schmidt's favorite subject, and to be honest, one of my least favorite subjects, was English. And one day, we were covering a grammar lesson, and all the students were quietly working at their desks on an exercise. I plowed through mine like normal. I slammed my pencil down and I shouted, "I'm done." Now, I thought Mrs. Schmidt was really going to be proud of me for being the first one that was done, but she just looked up at me and she sighed. And I think in retrospect, it's probably because I ruined the only 5 minutes of peace and quiet she was going to get that day. But she looked at me over those red reading glasses that she kept right at the tip of her nose, and she said, "Mr. Dixon, are you a cake? Because cakes are done. You are finished." And then she went back to working on whatever the heck she was doing, and I just squirmed a bit in my desk while my classmates giggled at me. But to answer your question, no, I'm not a cake, and I'm still not a cake to this day. But I think Mrs. Schmidt's distinction is a pretty good one, and it's a good description of this accomplishment today of your graduates. And I would suggest to you, though, that you might be done, but you are certainly not finished if the English faculty here and Mrs. Schmidt will continue to forgive my barbarity with the language, but you've reached a milestone. You're done with your time here at ECC. But you're all a long way from being finished with the greater work of your lives. Really, we all are. And throughout my life, I have continued to act like that sixth grade kid, plowing through my tasks. My wife, Melanie, and son, Eddie, and my dad here, Bob Dixon, they know better than anybody else that that sixth grade kid might be being a bit generous when it comes to my emotional development and my maturity. But I still rely on that same tried and true method in my life. Get the task done, get it through quickly. And growing up, all I wanted to do was to join the Marine Corps. The very moment that I was old enough to join that sign that enlistment contract, I did. Now, Marine Corps boot camp is the longest and the toughest of all the military in the entire world, and U.S. Marines are the best because of it. To my fellow veterans from the other branches here, you know what I mean, and I'm sure you all agree about the far superiority of Marines. Boot camp was just the beginning. And I remember at the very end of my training, one of the drill instructors told me that the hard part was still to come. The real work of being a Marine was not what we had just finished, boot camp, but what still lay ahead. And 3 years later in Afghanistan, I actually understood what he meant. But I don't think I really learned that lesson over the course of my life. After I left the service, I enrolled at community college. I had a singular focus: get in, get out, as quickly as possible so I could move on to the next thing. I just wanted to be done. And I did the same thing at the university and the same thing in grad school, done and done. So finally, when my schooling was over and I was ready to get on finally to what was next, I wasn't exactly sure what that was. I think I made it harder on myself because I don't often stop to smell the roses along the way. And so many times in life, you think you have it all figured out. I know that I do. You have a plan, you work the plan, and you get it done. But just as many times, though, when life hands you an opportunity or a challenge or a dead end, then your plan is out the window and you have to figure out what's next. In that moment, it can be sometimes difficult to figure out where you're going or to know where you're going. You sometimes feel like that old Yogi Berra line, when you come to a fork in the road, you take it. I'll let that sink in for just a second. But as you look back on your life, it becomes easier to see that this moment led to the next moment and to the next opportunity and so on. But you have to be ready to take advantage of those opportunities when they arise. And graduates, that's exactly what you have just done in your time here at ECC. Your accomplishment today represents the single best thing that you could have done to prepare yourselves for whatever life throws at you next. Your education here is literally the key that will unlock the next step and the next step and the next step, whatever that is. You've done it, but you're not finished. For some of you, you'll continue your education before heading into the workforce. And for others, I know you're ready to get to work right now. For many of you, I know finishing your education means just one less thing on your plate as you try to juggle home and life and family and everything else that you deal with. But we need you to not be finished. You are part of something bigger, and every single one of us has a job to do and a role to play. Right outside the doors of this room, there are businesses, there are people, there are communities that need you. They need your talent. They need your ideas. And our entire state truly depends on what you do next, graduates. Generations of Missourians have come before us, and they have done exactly what people from the Show Me State always do. They work hard, they provide for their families, and they take pride and they lead their communities. And every single one of those things makes our entire state and makes our society better. We might individually be just a cog in the greater system, but each one of us makes an important contribution. Remember, though, you are done today, but you're not finished. We need you to keep sharpening your talents and keep sharpening your skills. You need to continue your education, whether that's formally or informally. There are a lot of issues out there, problems that affect our communities, that affect our state, that affect our nation. And I'd submit to you that every single one of those problems, every single one of those issues can be solved by people like you, by people like us in this room. Now, we've made a decision to invest in ourselves. You've made that decision to invest in yourselves by graduating. And regardless of why you made that choice, we all have an obligation, though, to keep pushing ahead. To whom much is given, much is required. Now, I'm not suggesting that anybody gave you anything, graduates. You earned this day. You earned your degree through hard work and dedication. But now that you have the keys to help us all move forward, we need your help on the big challenges of our time. Now, taking care of yourselves, taking care of your families, is one of the most important obligations that we have as adults. But don't forget that you are part of a bigger community, and we need you to not be finished. If you look around this room, you'll see exactly what I mean. There are a lot of people here at East Central College that have helped you along the way. These are the folks that make it all happen. Many of them, you may never know who they are or what they did specifically, but rest assured that they're here and they're working hard every single day so that people like you and others, people like me, have had opportunities, greater opportunities than we could have had on our own. In my job, I have the privilege of working for and knowing these folks and their counterparts all across the state of Missouri, and they're the epitome of people who are not finished. They keep pushing for the greater good. Back in 1968, a group of people right here in your own community decided that you needed a community college. You needed it to make people's lives better, make your communities better. And those folks, they did something about it. When they saw that problem, they found a way to solve it. And we are here today, a generation later, because some regular people sat down and decided to do something about it. And now it's our turn, graduates. It's your turn. We have to keep going. You have to keep going, and you're all a long way from being finished. But for today, take a moment and relax and celebrate your accomplishments. Celebrate this moment in your life. But then tomorrow, get right back at it. Class of 2016, congratulations. You make all of us so extremely proud of you. Thank you for the opportunity to share this day with you, and congratulations again. Thank you.
Will the candidates for the associate degree and the vocational certificate please rise? President Bauer, upon the recommendation of the faculty of East Central College, I present to you these candidates for the associate degree and the vocational certificate.
By the authority of the State of Missouri and the Board of Trustees of East Central College, and on recommendation of the faculty of East Central College, I hereby confer upon each graduate the appropriate degree and/or certificate with all the rights, honors, and privileges appertaining thereto. Congratulations. You may move your tassel.
Rachel Lynn Cackley, honors. Jefferson Bernard Lampe, Phi Theta Kappa, honors. Casey Anna Kreider. Matthew Patrick Allison. Ashley Nicole Holdmeyer. Kelly Elizabeth Tershlusi. Shanda Lachey Ratcliffe. Lauren Eileen Dell. Brittany Nicole McDaniel, Phi Theta Kappa, highest honors. Megan Elizabeth Brown, Phi Theta Kappa, honors. Zeke Patrick Little, honors, Phi Theta Kappa. Anna Marie Tian, Phi Theta Kappa, highest honors. Hannah Marie Leslie. Amanda Louise Garth, Phi Theta Kappa, honors. Mercedes Blaine Love. Kristen Marie Bussa. Samantha Avis Shook. Drew Isaac Shook, Phi Theta Kappa, honors. Brianna Nicole Holmes, Phi Theta Kappa. Courtney Rose Lewis. Kimberly J. Hassler. Monica Michelle Hampton. Jonathan Robert Beaver. Joshua Tyler Adams. Shelly Ann Tyndall, Honors Phi Theta Kappa. Amber Marie Westholter, Honors. Richard L. Harmon, Honors Phi Theta Kappa. Teen Vin Hoon, Phi Theta Kappa, Honors. Simone Louise Bradley. Aaron James Bannister. Chad Michael Martin, Phi Theta Kappa. Brindolyn Rose Hayden. Dylan Roy Smith. Adam Joseph Hageman. Nagia Benzabi, Phi Theta Kappa. Matthew W. Tulloch. Sydney E. Phelps, Phi Theta Kappa. Madeline Irene Havelka, Honors. Brittany Ann Lobinger. Michaela Lynn Fisher. Anastasia Tess Burdick. Lindsay Ann Wagner. Jeffrey K. Brust II. Amy Marie Miller. Jake Ian Swanner. Chantel Madison Miller. Elizabeth Ann Duffer. Sarah Lynn Henneke, Phi Theta Kappa, Honors. Mary Jean Marie Sleeper, Phi Theta Kappa. Michaela Faith Acacia Matlock. Joseph Lee Graham, Phi Theta Kappa, Honors. Micah Michelle Wellnitz. Victoria Gail Witt, Phi Theta Kappa, Honors. Ty Allen Witt, Phi Theta Kappa, Highest Honors. Justin Richard Crooks. Elena A. Embry. Jacqueline Elizabeth Gerner. Brittany Elise Lee Porter. Charlotte Amanda Phipps. Maggie M. Steincipher. Kelsey L. Head. Andrea Jean Mittendorf. Rachel Lee Myers. Jennifer Marie Coleman, Phi Theta Kappa. Kelly M. Relig, Phi Theta Kappa Honors. Stephanie Ann Tershlusi, Phi Theta Kappa. Diana Lynn Ernst, Phi Theta Kappa Honors. Taylor M. Rich. Julia Marie Egan. James Michael Putman. Rachel K. Wagner. Shanai L. Marlett, Phi Theta Kappa Honors. Tara Jean Taylor. Ashley Elena Smith. Julie Allison Wiles, Phi Theta Kappa. Sierra Lynn Hawk, Phi Theta Kappa. Kiera Trinise Tyler. Kaylee Marie Auxier, Phi Theta Kappa. Nicole Marlin Tolliver. Christina Denise Symington. Brett Michael Glover, Phi Theta Kappa Honors. James Allen Waymeyer, Phi Theta Kappa Honors. Philip Gene Walker Honors. Gregory Kent Ard. Sarah Elizabeth Osick, U.S. Army. Jacob Anthony Osick, Phi Theta Kappa Honors. Ryan C. Daisy, Phi Theta Kappa Honors. Jake Wayne Lachlan. Nicholas Robert Henkel, Phi Theta Kappa Honors. Christopher S. Henkel, Phi Theta Kappa Honors. Crystal Ann Marie Glass, Phi Theta Kappa. Christy Danielle Cox Williams, Phi Theta Kappa. Sharon Denise O'Brien, Phi Theta Kappa. Brianna Irene Real. Bradley Douglas Hobbs. Nicholas Lundner. Deanna Marie Hill. Valerie Lynn Kreebaum. Brittany M. Sohn. Carissa Irene Pruitt. Whitney Aaron Noltensmeyer, Phi Theta Kappa. Rebecca Nicole Christian. Ashley Sue Menke. Jennifer Laura Lowe, Phi Theta Kappa. Chantel Marie O'Fallon. Heather Marie Spurgeon. Linda Ellen Helmig. Trisha Lee Oldham. Brittany Michelle Crosby. Ashley Michelle Brooks, Phi Theta Kappa. Kelly Lee Berkemeyer. Joseph John Lamzik. Heather Ann Reed. Amaron C. Crone. Daniel Nicole Messix. Elena Nicole Dye. Jordan Gail Pate. Malia L. Metz. Bria J. Bartolotta. Andrea Anita Hartwick. Taylor Renee Rickerson. Alyssa N. Steinberg. Ashlyn Lane Cook Honors. Cameron Michael Pilkington Honors. Brittany Danielle Kenser. Stephen K. Danzo. Elise Suzanne Magner. Alexia B. Decker. Sarah Elizabeth Bolte, highest honors. Twyla Ann Dyer, honors. Anjanette Denise Candlebinder, Phi Theta Kappa, honors. Dora Lynn Lafferty, Phi Theta Kappa, honors. Ashley Paige Horn, Phi Theta Kappa. Jessica Renee McCoy, honors. Christina M. Evans. Madeline Darby Ogan.
The Outstanding Student Award is the highest award given to an East Central College graduate. It is usually awarded to one student who embodies academic excellence and contributes to the life of the campus community. The honoree is selected by a vote of the faculty and staff who thoughtfully consider academic achievements as well as extracurricular involvement. This year, there was a tied vote. The outstanding students for 2016 are Zeke Little and Anna Marie Tian. A little about each of them. In her time at ECC, Anna Marie Tian has been an ambassador for the ECC Music Department. She has provided the music for ECC Community Day, playing piano in the atrium while prospective students sought out information about the music program. She has performed as an accompanist at a music night sponsored by the college, and she has volunteered as a pianist for many ECC external events. Ms. Tian is committed to volunteerism and has performed many hours of community and civic service here in Franklin County over the last several years. In addition to service work that she has done at her church, she is an active member of 4-H and has led many important initiatives for that organization. Ms. Tian's academic honors at East Central College include membership in Phi Theta Kappa, state recognition at the Missouri Music Teachers Association Collegiate State Competition, multiple scholarships awarded by the ECC Music Department, and today, after making the president's academic honors list every semester that she has attended East Central, she graduates with highest honors. In his time at ECC, Zeke Little has also been an ambassador for the college, but his passion is in a different area. Since 2014, Zeke has been the starting goalkeeper for our soccer team, the ECC Falcons. During his time at East Central, he was nationally recognized by the National Soccer Coaches Association of America as a Scholar All-American. He was voted to the Missouri Community College Athletic Conference First Team All-Conference. He led the Falcons to 3 wins by shutout, and he helped lead the team to back-to-back Region 16 championship games. Mr. Little has also shown great commitment in the area of volunteerism. For 2 consecutive years, he answered the call for help from the Special Olympics. He has worked with the Missouri Special Olympics Spring Games as well as the Special Olympics Soccer Games. Coach Keen Barclay describes Mr. Little as someone that cares about others and shows how much he cares in his actions. According to Coach Barclay, he's close with his family and he takes care of his friends. He's got a great sense of humor, and he can take a joke as well as giving one out. He's endured some injuries in his time as an athlete, but has always been a great supporter to his teammates and never makes excuses. A Phi Theta Kappa member as well, Mr. Little graduates with high honors. This fall, Anna Marie Tian will transfer to Missouri State University to pursue a bachelor's degree in music, piano performance, and Zeke Little will transfer to Quincy University to pursue a Bachelor of Science in nursing. Please join me in recognizing this year's recipients of the Outstanding Student of the Year, Zeke Little and Anna Marie Tian.
Union native Dave Arend, a 1975 graduate of East Central College, is the 2016 recipient of the Outstanding Alumni Award. Established by the East Central College Alumni Association in 2002, the award recognizes outstanding alumni who have set an example for ECC graduates by using their college education and serving their community. A 1973 graduate of Union High School, Aaron began his post-secondary education that fall at what was then East Central Junior College. Aaron was a member of both the basketball and baseball teams during his 2 years at East Central, then called the East Central Rebels. After graduating with an Associate of Arts degree in 1975, he transferred to Southeast Missouri State University in Cape Girardeau. He obtained his bachelor's degree from SEMO in 1977 and went on to earn his law degree from Washburn University. Aaron has spent his entire life working and serving the community. As a young man, his leadership and service were recognized when he received the Outstanding Young Man Award from the JCs. That award was based on countless hours working with the Union Kiwanis, Knights of Columbus, Union Board of Aldermen, East Central College Foundation, Union High School Booster Club, and Immaculate Conception Parish. He spent many hours coaching youth soccer, baseball, softball, and basketball. While staying active in the community, Aaron has built a reputation as a fair and honest attorney. His private law practice has grown over the years, but he always finds time to use his legal knowledge to help local organizations with advice and assistance. He also serves the communities of Union and St. Clair as city judge. His fairness, along with compassion and respect for the law, has made him successful in those positions. Aaron continues to give his time to organizations in the area. Most recently, he served as president of the Union Kiwanis Club. He's a member of the Knights of Columbus and serves on the Finance Committee at Immaculate Conception Parish. Aaron is extremely proud of his position on the Franklin County Community Resource Board, where he has helped distribute millions of tax dollars to agencies serving the youth of Franklin County. Dave and his wife Dinah live in Union. They are the parents of four children and have four grandchildren. His proudest moments as an East Central alum came when two of his sons, Dane and Devin, decided to attend ECC and play soccer. Although his daughter Danielle did not attend as a full-time student, she took summer classes here and participated in numerous theater productions. The Aaron family has been deeply involved with East Central over the years. Dave's father, Ray, served on the Board of Trustees, and his brother, Chris, coached and directed student activities at East Central. I am pleased to present to you the outstanding alumnus for 2016, my good friend, Dave Aaron.
Congratulations. Let's step in front and get a picture here.
President Bauer, thank you for those kind words. Board of Trustees, administration, faculty, graduates, guests. I want to thank you very much for this award. First, I need to thank my family for being here. I'd like them to stand. My mother is here. Juanita Aaron, my wife, Dinah, my daughter, Danielle Clapper, and her husband, East Central's own Eric Clapper. He's the director of high school relations for East Central. Their daughter, the apple of my eye, Avery. My son, Dane, and his wife, Ashley, and my son, Devin. Can't believe it's been 41 years. I hope I don't look that old. Since I graduated from East Central. I actually recently viewed some photos of my East Central graduation, and in that photo, sticking out from the bottom of my gown that I wore on graduation day, were my big blue and gray, large cuffed dress bell-bottom pants. They were cool back then. But thank God, fashion changes and grows and evolves, all for the better. Similarly, East Central College has definitely changed and grown for the better. When I graduated from here, there were only two buildings, this building and a much smaller version of the administration building. And actually, my basketball team was the first team to play in this building. So that tells you how long it's been. Since I graduated, East Central has built the VOTEC building, the auditorium building, the classroom building, the health and science building, and renovated the administration building. Baseball fields, softball fields, the soccer field, the walking track were all added after I left. When I was here, East Central offered me the opportunity to obtain a quality education and continue my basketball and baseball pursuits. The competition level when I was here and continues was incredible. And the challenges and the quality of the courses that I took when I was here were incredible as well. And they more than prepared me for the continued education at SEMO and Washburn Law School. Graduates, I think you will find, most of you will find, that if you made it here, if you succeeded here, you will succeed wherever you go. Because the classes that you took here are just as demanding, if not more demanding, than those you will find when you go on. Unfortunately, neither of the sports that I played here no longer exist. But if we had crowds like this at our games, we might still have basketball. I don't know. But East Central has continued to impact my life with its positive growth and the opportunities it offered. Since I graduated, my father served on the Board of Trustees for a number of years. My youngest brother, Chris, was basketball coach here for a few years. My wife took golf lessons from my baseball coach, Tom Dill, who was a trustee here for many years. And now golfing together is one of our favorite pastimes. My sons, Dane and Devin, both received athletic and academic scholarships here and had great soccer and academic careers here that served after the graduation as a springboard to continued successes in soccer and education at Fonbonne University. My daughter Danielle, though not an East Central grad, she graduated from University of Central Missouri. She obtained her vocal training here at East Central that helped her in many musical productions, including Borgia High School, community theater, and while in high school as a performer at Six Flags in Eureka. After college, East Central offered her the opportunity to perform in many of its productions. If any of you have never been to an East Central production, a theater production, you don't know what you've missed. Again, the talent level here is incredible. Likewise, if you've never been to a sporting event, particularly I'm partial to soccer games, but if you've never been to one of those, you don't know what you've missed. We have incredible athletes here. I've witnessed theater productions at the highest level. My wife and I love to go to the Muni, and I've witnessed athletic events at the highest level. And we're fortunate to have both of those things here at that type of level. In any event, and to conclude, because I know the last thing you want to hear is a long speech from the last person on. I guess I didn't actually say the best for last, but in any event, I'm honored and humbled by this award, and I can't thank East Central and the Alumni Association enough for this. I'll always cherish it. Thank you very much.
Ladies and gentlemen, as we conclude today's ceremony, the board and I invite you to a reception in honor of our graduates. The reception will be held downstairs in the cafeteria. That's one floor down from here. As we leave, please remain seated until all of the graduates have left the gym. And now let us congratulate once more our distinguished alumnus, our outstanding students, and the 2016 graduates of East Central College. Dr. Mahon.